We've got my friend, my mentor, my colleague, Walter Himmel, clearing up any confusion you might have when it comes to nystagmus.
Now, here's the most important question that's going to plague you the rest of your career. And if you can figure this out, life will be beautiful. Is the person having a stroke or do they have vestibular neuritis? Is that dizzy patient? Is that vertiginous patient? Is it central or is it peripheral? Which one is it? If you know nystagmus, then you can get a pretty good idea if the patient's having a central problem or a peripheral. Central means stroke. Central means the lantan toxicity. Central means multiple sclerosis. Central means tumor. What does peripheral mean? Peripheral means vestibular neuritis or BPPV. Basically, nystagmus is absolutely, fundamentally crucial and totally misunderstood. First of all, what is nystagmus? Nystagmus is involuntary movement of the eyes, which continues. Now, there are two kinds of nystagmus, basically jerk nystagmus and pendular nystagmus. Jerk nystagmus and pendular. Well, let's get pendular out of the way. Pendular nystagmus means the eyes are moving back and forth and back and forth in a sinusoidal manner. I'm not going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about jerk nystagmus. Now, why is it called jerk nystagmus? Well, I'll tell you why. It's pretty obvious. Your eyes move slowly in one direction and whoop, quickly in the other direction. Your eyes move slowly to the right and then rapidly to the left. Slowly to the right and jerk to the left. Or your eyes move slowly to the left and jerk to the right. Jerk nystagmus means there's two components, a slow movement in one direction and then a fast movement to correct it. I'm talking about jerk nystagmus. Now, some jerk nystagmuses are typical of central and some jerk nystagmuses are typical for peripheral. So let's go through this and I'll try to be very clear. I will tell you what's always peripheral, almost always. I'll tell you what's always central, and I mean always central, and I'll tell you where you can't be sure. So, let's get the easy one out of the way. What kind of nystagmus is always central? If you have pure vertical nystagmus, that's always central. Now, don't be fooled. If you've got benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, you will have inducible nystagmus. And to the unexperienced person, you will think it's central, and I'll tell you why. The nystagmus of benign paroxysmal positional vertigo is vertical rotatory. Vertical rotatory. With BPPV, the nystagmus is the following. The eyes move up and they rotate to the right. Now, if you've never seen it, it's hard to believe. Google it and you'll see some videos. Back to central. If it's purely vertical, if it's beating purely up or purely down with no rotational element, that is always central. No questions asked. So if the person looks up, the eyes beat up quickly and down slowly. Look up quickly and down slowly. That's jerk nystagmus. It's purely vertical. It's always central. Now, what else is always central? If it's purely rotational nystagmus. The eyes actually move in a circular manner. Yes, it actually exists. So you've got somebody, upon examination of their eyes, you notice their eyes are moving clockwise. You know, they move from 12 o'clock to 2 o'clock, back to 12 to 2 o'clock, back to 12, and it's purely rotatory. That's always central. So now we know what's always central. Purely vertical or purely rotatory is always central. So point one out of the way. Now, let's move on. When you've got nystagmus, it's slowly in one direction and quickly in the other. That's called jerk nystagmus. The nystagmus is named by the direction of the quick component. If your eyes slowly move to the right and quickly to the left, it's called jerk nystagmus to the left. So let's talk about peripheral nystagmus. In plain words, the nystagmus of BPPV or the nystagmus of acute vestibular urinitis. And here's exactly what it's like. With vestibular urinitis, you've got continuous nystagmus. And with vestibular urinitis, nystagmus is always, always unidirectional. For example, if you've got vestibular urinitis involving the right ear, you will have a nystagmus. And nystagmus is the following. It will move slowly to the right ear and quickly to the left. Now, if you look to the right, it'll move slowly to the right and quickly to the left. If you look to the left, it'll move slowly to the right and quickly to the left. So with peripheral nystagmus, such as in labyrinthitis or such as in vestibular urinitis, doesn't matter where you look, the fast component will always be in the same direction. Now, there's something called Alexander's Law, which means the following. And you will see this time and time again. When you look in the direction of the fast component, it's always more obvious. When you look in the direction of the slow component, the nystagmus is always less obvious, but it always beats in the same direction. So if nystagmus is jerk nystagmus and unidirectional, which is named from the fast component, it's almost always peripheral. Now, I didn't say always. I said almost always. Next patient. Let's say you've got a patient, and if you look to the right, the fast component is to the right. And if you look to the left, the fast component is to the left. Is that unidirectional? No, it's bidirectional. Their fast component is always in the direction you're looking at. This is never peripheral. If they have bidirectional nystagmus, it's virtually always central. So who has bidirectional nystagmus? Well, people who are very drunk have bidirectional nystagmus because the alcohol has poisoned their brain. People with dilatant toxicity have bidirectional nystagmus. Why is that? Because the dilatant has poisoned their brain. And this is quite funny. Next time you've got a patient with dilatant toxicity or is really drunk, look at their eyes. And you'll notice this. The more you look, the more you'll see. When you look up, their eyes beat up. When you look down, their eyes beat down. When you look to the right, their eyes beat to the right. When you look to the left, their eyes beat to the left. Or if you're having a stroke, the same will virtually always happen. So now we know the following. Unidirectional nystagmus is almost always peripheral. Multidirectional nystagmus is virtually always central. So now, what have we learned so far? Purely vertical is always central. Purely rotational is always central. Unidirectional, the fast component is always in the same direction, is virtually always peripheral. And multidirectional is virtually always central. So what else do you have to know? Well, there's only one other question. Is the nystagmus spontaneous or is it evoked? Now, what do I mean by that? Well, it's very simple. The patient's sitting up and looking at you. You have not done the Hintz test. You have not done a head impulse test. You have not done an index Hallpike test. You've done nothing. And your eyes are demonstrating nystagmus. Second after second, minute after minute, after minute after minute. This is called continuous nystagmus. That could be central or it could be peripheral. Now, I'll tell you why it's important to know. Continuous nystagmus is never benign, paroxysmal, positional, vertical. Continuous nystagmus, minute after minute, hour after hour, is either central or peripheral. And if the continuous nystagmus is unidirectional, it's peripheral labyrinthitis. Now, how about triggered nystagmus? What does that mean? Well, the patient's sitting quietly, and you look at their eyes, there's no nystagmus. But if you turn their head or they sit up, you see nystagmus. But it ends after 30 seconds or a minute and a half. That's called evoked nystagmus, also known as transient nystagmus, also known as temporary nystagmus. If your nystagmus is evoked, and if it lasts less than a minute or two, You are not dealing with vestibular neuritis. You are not dealing with a stroke. You're dealing with benign paroxysmal positional vertigo and sometimes a very rare thing called central positional vertigo. And that's it. So we know what nystagmus is. It's movement slowly in one direction, quick in the other. That's called jerk nystagmus. Now we know if it's purely vertical, it's always central. If it's purely rotational, it's always central. If it's multidirectional, it's central. And if it's unidirectional, it's almost always peripheral. And now we also know that if it's inducible and lasting less than a minute and a half, it's either central positional vertigo, almost unheard of, or BPPV. And remember, BPPV is not rotational, it's not vertical, it's vertical rotatory. And it's almost always unidirectional. And that's all you have to know. And that's it, folks. Now you're experts.
Nystagmus finally cleared up.